our sanctuary with our Wednesday night service. Glad to have those that are here. Good to have you streaming with us tonight. We appreciate you being along with us tonight. Pray that you'll be blessed. A welcome to our worship service tonight. I want to keep praying for the most recent prayer request we've had. God's protection on all with COVID, during COVID-19, heard some new cases this week. People, even a neighbor of mine, remember to pray for all the prayer line requests. Pray for Ralph and Shirley and Greg. They need special touch tonight. Charles and Lois Clark, Debbie Brooks. And Debbie had a special request that she wanted to pray for Cooper Burrow, who has brain cancer. Chad Bridges and his mom, Vernon and Debbie West, Geraldine Buford, and all my sisters that need a touch tonight. Dee Dee Woody and her daughter Sue, Kayleen Kay Eason, and also Kay's sister Cheryl had a son to get killed over the weekend in an automobile accident. Pray for that family. Pray for Nettie Tigg. She's still battling sickness in her body. Pray for Wendell Weaver. Keep praying for Steve Fuel, Sister Annie, and Sister Colleen. All of them recovering from some surgery and different things that they had. Pray for Debbie's son-in-law, John, that God will continue to touch him. Pray for Louise Grant. She needs a miracle. She was here Sunday night, but she needs a special touch. Pray for Gail's dad, Brother Foster. Pray for my brother-in-law, Charles Shook, and my sister, Betty. And again, my other sisters, Marcella and Eddie, all of those that need a touch tonight. Pray for Sister Kat Wilson and Roy Wilson. They've both been sick. They're not here tonight. Pray for them. Pray for Logan Fletcher. Talked to him today. He's still believing God for a miracle for him. Mentioned Greg Wilson earlier, but do pray for him. Pastor Poole had eye surgery Monday, and I talked to him yesterday when he was about getting back to Kings Mountain. Everything went well, and he was thankful for that. Keep praying for Don Mara's mom. They still don't seem to know what her problem is. She went back to another doctor today. I talked to Don. He told her a lot of A, B, C, D things it could be, but didn't really give her anything, that let her know what was wrong. Amen. So just be praying for all these. Pray for all the bereaved families. Pray for our missions. Pray for our TV ministry. Pray for the church. Pray for all three of our churches, Dallas and Gastonia, Mooresboro. And unspoken requests, let God see your hand tonight. Anybody up here have one you'd like to add to the list or something?
Lisa,
okay. New folks here, missed them already, so just pray for them tonight. Anybody else up here? Charlie's been sick, keep praying for her. And they plan to go on vacation next week. She's trying to get better where they can go, so just keep praying for her. Anybody out here tonight have one you'd like to speak? Anybody? Anybody? All right.
My friend Angie's husband that I've been requesting prayer for, she's looking real bad. She's trying to make some decisions today.
All right.
I don't know if he's conscious. I think he's on the ventilator. So just pray for the name, Rick.
All right. Pray for that. Good to see you this year tonight. Got a faithful few here tonight, but we appreciate them being here. And those that's not here, we miss them tonight. Some of them are hindered, like Natty. Always with us on Wednesday night service, and the Wilsons, several different ones, is not able to make it tonight. We miss them. We're glad to have you here. Let's stand and go to the Lord in prayer. Praise the Lord. Let Tommy come around and lead us to the Lord in prayer, and then he'll take over with the singing. Worship with him as he comes tonight. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Heavenly Father, we just thank you for another opportunity to be in your house tonight, Lord. Pray, Lord God, we'll be worthy to worship
Father,
you,
we love
Lord
you
God.
Tonight. Thank you, Jesus.
Have way in this service tonight.
May your blessings be upon
us. All these requests have been brought forth, Lord. We just believe and trust in you to reach down and touch, Lord God. Deliver,
Jesus,
Lord. Heal our bodies, Lord. Uplift them, Jesus. We thank you and praise you for that, Lord. For the ones that don't know what's wrong, Lord, you know what's wrong. You can change things, Lord. Turn it around, Lord. We thank you for that. For the Wilsons, touch them, Lord. Uplift them tonight. Give them a miracle, Lord. We thank you for that, Jesus. For each and every one, for Gail's dad, Lord God, just touch him, heal his body, Lord. Be with him. For Rhonda Manners tonight, Lord God, touch her and heal her and uplift her, Jesus. Be with her, Jesus. For Sister Nettie, Lord, uplift her and all the ones that's been mentioned tonight, Lord. We just put them before you, Jesus, and believing in great things, Lord, that we might have your way, Jesus. In your name we pray, Lord. Amen. of page 268, and it'll also be on the board. I was alone and idle, I was a sinner too. I heard a voice from heaven saying there is work to do. I took my master's hand and I joined the heavenly band. Now I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. Now I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. Yes, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. I promised him that I would serve him till I die. Now I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. I lost my flag in battle, my staff is in my hand. I'm taking it to Jesus over in glory land. In distant land I tried, crying, sinner, come to God. Now I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. Now I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. Yes, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. I promised him that I would serve him till I die. Now I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. I'm fighting for my Savior. The battle is most won. The trumpet will be sounding, the coming of the sun. I'll lay my armor down, take up my robe and crown. Then I'll walk the golden street with my Lord. Now I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. Yes, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. I promised him that I would serve him till I die. Now I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. Now I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. I promised him that I would serve him till I die. Now I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. Take up tithes and offerings tonight. Brother Harvey, if you would, pray with the offering.
Your last ounce of hope is gone. My name will never 17 years today that we started that trial and we got through it, you know, and it probably did seem like Mount Everest when we were there, but we got through it and we come through alive, you know. It was another one that the devil thought he was going to take us out, and that didn't happen. So
right. Amen.
I praise the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Soon and very soon. And if you're sick and tired of this world as I am, we're ready to go, right?
That's right, amen. Yes.
And I feel like he's just about ready to come and get us too, because I think in the hearts of every Christian we're saying, Lord, come get me and get us out of this mess. We can't go on much longer, you know?
Yes.
And I see the signs of his appearing every day. Yes. I mean, every time they open their mouth, it's just another sign of the Bible that they're talking about. And I'm saying, well, it's going to be soon. I don't know when, but I know it's going to be soon.
soon and very soon.
Stores and the gas stations or anything like that. I thought, Lord, what would we do? We'll starve. He said, I've never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging for bread. And we were sitting at the house the other day, just a little bitty bird flew into the back window there. I didn't know what it was. I said, did you do something, James? He said, no. He came. The little bird just looked like he just broke his neck and fell over. And I thought, well, I can't go out the door, so I went and got the shovel. I was going to move him over, and as soon as I turned him over, he spread those wings and he flew right out of there. Amen. I said, you know, if God sees a sparrow when it falls to the ground and he picks it up and he heals it, and it just flew away. And I thought, well, you know, it's going to die. It came up, it sat on the porch a while, and it just flew away. But he was looking out after that little bird.
Yes.
If he's going to look out after that bird, how much more precious am I? Because I'm his child.
Yes.
He will look out after us, and he'll take care of us. Should there be any rivers we must cross, and they might. Or mountains that you must climb, or they might, but he will supply whatever you need to get through it. I really believe it's coming to down to where, you know, we're not going to get off scot-free. I mean, I believe in the rapture as much as the next person, but I do believe that the Christians are going to be persecuted. They were in the Bible, and we will be again. You might as well, get ready to fight. You know, just get ready to fight for it. That's just what I believe.
Yes. Yes.
Amen. Should there be any rivers we must cross? Should there be any mountains we must climb? God will supply all the faith that we need. Give us grace till we reach another side.
Aren't you glad of that today? Amen. Aren't you glad that God will give us strength to, if we are standing at Mount Everest, if we're looking at the river and it's deep and wide, we just got to follow the footsteps of the guide and go on through. Amen. Amen. Have your Bibles tonight, and do thank you for being with us tonight. You that are here and you that are live streaming with us, we're so glad to have you with us. Text in, let us know you're listening. Have prayer requests, give us those, and brought Donnie will give them to me at the end of the service, and we'll pray over them and believe God to touch you tonight. Amen. I only have one short verse of scripture from a very popular book in the Bible, the book of Jonah. Everybody knows about that book. There's four little chapters there, and how that God moved in spite of Jonah. Amen. In spite of Jonah, and Jonah suffered a great loss there. Amen. Because it didn't end well, according to the way I understand the fourth chapter. Amen. One of the last things God asked him was, are you still sorrowful? In our terms, are you still mad? And he said, unto death. Amen. I'm so mad I could die. What a terrible way to end your conversation with God. Yes. Because if you got a problem with God, you better get your end fixed, because there's not anything wrong on the other end.
That's
amen.
Right. Yes.
I can promise you tonight. Want to look at what Jonah said. I've preached every angle I thought I could take from this book, but I found a new one last night when I was studying. And I want to take one verse of scripture in Jonah's prayer, verse 1 through 10 of chapter 2 is all of his prayer. But I want to go to the fourth verse and something he said, and it just touched my heart when I read it last night. Read it with me. It's just a short verse there. Just simply says, then I said, Job said that, then I said, I am cast out of thy sight, yet I will look again toward the holy temple.
Amen.
And I said it. Job said, I said that. I am cast out of thy sight, yet I will look again toward the holy temple. Amen. Amen. I want to talk to you tonight. Look at God one more time. Amen. Amen. Father, we love you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord, for this opportunity of prayer. May not be an Easter message, but yet it might be, Lord. We look at the cross one more time. Take one more look at Mount Calvary, the songwriter said, and it gives me the strength to go on, Lord. I pray that you'll help us tonight in every way as we stand to preach your word, Lord, that you'd give us what you'd have to say and to touch somebody going through a trial that may feel like that they're cast out of God's sight. Yet one more time, they're going to look to the temple. Amen. One more time, they're going to look to God. Look at God one more time. Amen. Amen. Wave at somebody before you see it. If we wave at you on the live streaming there, so glad to have you with us tonight. Feel like some of you probably waving at us. We're so glad to have you with us tonight. Jonah was simply saying there in that short verse, in the middle of his prayer, almost the middle of his prayer, 10 verses. I think he was saying there, I thought I was a goner. Amen. God quit looking at me and I couldn't see him. Amen. That's a terrible place to be in life. Amen. If you feel like you can't find God and you don't feel like he's looking at you anymore, what a terrible thing that is. And for Jonah, it was almost like he said, there's no way I can get back. I mean, God's quit looking at me. I can't see him. I'm wrapped in all this seaweed in the middle of this fish's belly, and I can't see God. And I think he's hid his face from me, and there's no way for me to get back. Amen. I believe probably no doubt, because he goes on to say, I'll pay the vow. But I believe no doubt he was saying, I wished I could get on that ship one more time and tell them to let me off and let me go to Nineveh and preach. Amen. And while he was thinking that, probably God was still on the throne and God hadn't quit looking at him. God saw him there and God knew what was going on. Amen. No matter how, notice he said, I will look again. Lets me know something. He'd been here before. He'd been one more time when he thought, I'll just walk away from God if nothing else, when he got on that boat. You know, when he got on that boat going to Joppa. They say, I've studied that before, not lately, but I did look at it. Joppa was as far as you could go from where he was in the little known world at that time. He went to Joppa. I believe he got on there and said, take me as far as you're going. You know, in our day, and he didn't want to get in the water, you say, take me to California. That's the other side of the nation here. And that's kind of what he did. He said, I want to go as far away as I can go. And I believe he thought momentarily to get away from God, found out he couldn't. David said, if I ascend to the heavens, you're there. If I descend to hell, you're there. I can't get away from God. It doesn't matter how tough you are tonight. Listen to me. It doesn't matter how tough you are. When you get where Jonah was, it'll cause you to look back at God one more time. Amen.
Amen.
You think you've done everything you know to do. And I heard Jeff Burrell when I was a young man. He was just a young man. Fiery evangelist, and he preached a message entitled one night, Mr. Big Stuff, Who Do You Think You Are? Amen. And me and Jimmy used to talk about that. We were there. Jimmy liked that message as well. But Mr. Big Stuff, Who Do You Think You Are? And again, I'm going to say it doesn't matter how tough you are. If you ever get where Jonah was at, you can't see God. You don't think he's looking at you. It'll cause you to start looking for him.
Amen.
One more time and to take one more look at him. Jonah was remembering as the church at Ephesus was told by Jesus in the seven letters to the churches in Revelation. He said, remember from whence you are fallen and repent. Jonah knew where he went wrong. Amen. You know, everybody's got a story. Everybody's got a song. We're all a little different, but we all went wrong. Then Jesus came, thank God for Easter, and changed everything. Amen. Aren't you glad? But it was more than that with Jonah. All his hope was gone, but he looked to God one more time. I feel like I just could imagine, and in my mind, since we do live streaming, and maybe there's nobody here, and it could be somebody here, but I just felt in my spirit that there'd be somebody that I'm talking to tonight that's just about through with God, just about ready to throw in the towel, quit, ready to say, I'm not going to look at him anymore. And like some of the patriarchs of old thought they were finished, but they weren't, and you're not either, if you'll just take one more look to God tonight. I feel like I'm speaking to somebody, as I said, and I may say that again before I get through. Amen. David felt like this when he was fleeing from Absalom, his son. In Psalms chapter 3 and verse 2, he said these words, many there be which say of my soul, there is no help for him in God. Amen. David felt like that. Even God, people were looking at him and the trouble he was in, being sought by Absalom and saying there ain't no hope for him. If the Absalom don't get him, Saul will. Saul don't get him, Absalom will. If they don't, the devil will. He's a goner. Amen. And he said, many there be that say there's no hope for him in God. So he tried what I'm preaching tonight. He looked one more time at God. That's what he did. Amen. Look one more time at God. In verse 4, he said, I cried unto the Lord, still in chapter 2 of Psalm. I cried unto the Lord with my voice, and he heard me out of his holy hill. Amen. I'll thank God for that reference there. Going to look one more time to the holy temple. And David said, I cried unto him, and he hold me. He heard me from the holy hill. Amen. Praise the Lord. That holy place. Amen. Great men and women of God have had to do this. Even Peter in Matthew 26 and 75, verse 75, it says, Peter remembered the word of Jesus, which he said unto him, before the cock crow, thou shalt deny me thrice. And you know the story he just had. And the last line of that verse said, he went out and wept bitterly. Amen. He took one more look at God. He saw him and remembered his words. Amen. Maybe he felt like God wasn't looking at him. I don't know. Maybe he did. I feel like, again, I'm talking to someone tonight who thinks looking back to God one more time would just be a futile in your life. It wouldn't amount to anything because God's give up on you and you give up on him. But I was reminded of the song I think they sing, he never gave up on me. Amen.
Right.
If you give up on God, that's you. But he never has. Most of us here are seniors tonight, or the majority, there's a few that's middle-aged here tonight, but don't have a lot of young people here. But what we do have is people that represent a lot of young people. We got nieces and nephews and daughters and sons that we wish was here tonight, hearing this word of God tonight, that they ought to look at God one more time. Somebody say amen. Hallelujah. I feel like I'm talking to somebody like that tonight. But I want you to not forget about his mercy. He's merciful tonight. I said he's merciful. Amen. And the Bible said he'll show mercy on whom he will. Amen. And I believe that. I believe that if you're the one that needed the worst tonight, he can give it to you right now, that mercy. And then you'll be like the song Jimmy Swaggart used to sing, mercy rewrote my life. Amen. Amen. I could have fallen in sin, sank way down, but mercy rewrote my life. Amen. I'm sure there's people in hell who would wish tonight that they had looked at God one more time before they left this world. Somebody hear me tonight. I believe that. The devil would like to make you think there's no hope for you in God, as they said about David. But God can do anything, and he loves you enough to do anything for you. Amen. He loves you enough to do anything for you tonight. Somebody hear me One more time. Even in our earthly trials, Peter would not have got out of prison had the church not prayed. Somebody looked to God one more time. We like to sing the song around here, "Somebody prayed for me." Amen. Thank God for those prayers of people that pray for us. Amen. And he never would have got out of prison had the church not prayed. Paul and Silas would not have got out of jail, and the jailer would not have been saved in Acts chapter 16 had they not prayed in the midnight hour and sang praises to God. Amen. It'll make all the difference if you'll just take one more look back at God again. If you'll just direct your attention back to him one more time and see what God can do about it, the situation in your life, and you'll be amazed at how he can work it out. Amen. Just when I thought there was no way, he led me to a brighter day, the songwriter said. Hallelujah. Jesus, you're everything to me. Amen. Amen. The disciples would have died on that stormy sea had they not woke up the master that night. They woke him up and said, "Carest not that we perish." Made sure he was looking at them. They were looking at him, and they lived to face another day. Somebody say amen. Amen. I believe that with all my heart. Amen. As we look back to the text, we see in verse 1 that Jonah prayed to God where he was. Verse 1 says he was in the fish's belly. Amen. Yeah. He was in the fish's belly. Sometimes we'd like to get to the place that we can pray, and the reality is that you just got to pray where you are. Amen. Where you are right now, if you're at the hospital tonight with a loved one that's facing death, or if you're the one that the doctors talked to lately and said you got a terminal illness and you're not going to live, you got to pray to God right where you are. Amen. If you're in the fish's belly, if you're at the foot of Mount Everest, if the river looks too wide, whatever it looks like in your life, if I could just stress that tonight, you can't get to a place to pray. You got to pray right where you are now, in the battle you're in the valley you're in. Somebody say, amen. I believe that's important. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. You gotta praise him where you at and pray where you at. Amen. He was in the fish's belly. Amen. Somebody hear me tonight. The devil would make you think there's no hope and you can't make it. But I'm telling you, you can. Amen. You can make it tonight. Amen. In verse 2, he says, "I cried by reason of mine infliction." He wasn't just crying. He was crying tears of pain tonight in verse 2. And I think that's real important that we realize that there's a praise song that says, "If I run, know I'm running as one's been set free. If I shout, know I'm shouting as one has been redeemed." Amen. May have messed the words up there, but that's the essence of the message tonight. And this is the other way around. If I'm crying out to God, you know I'm in a battle. You know, if I'm crying out to God, if I'm really, there's something in my cry. God knows the pain you feel. He can touch and he can heal. The song says, "Take your burdens to the Lord and leave them there." That's what you and I have got to do. Somebody say amen.
Amen. That's right. Amen.
Amen. Amen. In verse 3, he said, "It was all over my head, the seaweed's all over me." You know, it's just covered me. I'm in the mess of this belly of this fish, and I can't see God. I don't even think he sees me. I don't think he even knows where I'm at. Probably forgot my name. If he didn't think that, the devil was telling him that. Amen. And somebody sung a song reference to that tonight. He does know your name. When the devil makes you think, he's forgot it. Amen. But then we get to our text verse. In verse 4, he said, "I'm out of his sight. He don't even see me." Amen. That's the worst feeling you could have. You know, we strive sometimes to get away from God. And then when we get away from him, it's the worst feeling you can ever have. Amen. You feel like you're lost and undone without God or his son. And you need him to reach down his hand for you tonight. I feel like somebody gets saved streaming with us tonight. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. In verse 5, he said, "The elements around me have hid me." Amen. Verse 5, "The waters compassed me, even to the soul. The death closed me round about. The weeds were wrapped around my head. Aren't you glad when it's over, your head is under his feet? Amen. Amen. Aren't you glad that when you can't see the way, he can see the way? Amen. He knows how he's going to get us out of this thing. Verse 6 says, he said, I went down to the bottoms of the mountains. The earth with her bars was about me forever. Yet hast thou brought up my life from corruption, O Lord, my God. In verse 6, and I summarized that verse and says, he said, I went down, but God brought me up. Amen. Why did he do that? Because he looked at him one more time. Amen. He made his eyes fasten back on God one more time just to see what God will do in his life. Somebody needs to look at God one more time. Somebody just, you threw in the towel. You said you're going to quit. You ain't never going back to church again. I won't ever darken a church door again. I don't even want them to take me there when I die. I don't want to have my, I'm through with God. I'm through with the church. I'm telling you, you need to look at God one more time. Somebody say amen. I believe that. Amen. Hallelujah. Verse 7 is interesting. It says, when my soul fainteth within me, I remember the Lord, and my prayer came into thee and into thy holy temple. Verse 7. I want to tell you what I think that verse is saying. Right before my lights went out, I remembered the Lord. Right before I couldn't breathe anymore. Right before I went to sleep with sleep apnea and died during the night, right before my heart attacked and I left this world, I remembered God one more time. Somebody say amen. Amen. So important. Amen. And then verse 7 says, right before my lights went out, I remember the Lord. My prayer made it to him. Thank God it touched him. Somebody say amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. And then verse 9 just simply says, I praised him. And he got me out, amen. Verse 10 said the fish got sick, vomited him up on the dry land, and he got a chance to go a three-day journey in a day. Went, got on the ball, amen, doing what God told him to do to start with, amen. Jonah got in trouble because he tried to play God. That's what he was doing. You know, you think about it. He was trying to play God. Jonah thought the wayward Ninevites did not deserve to repent. Amen. They weren't, you know, they weren't worth saving, is what he thought. Just get rid of them. And he knew that if he went down there and told them what God told him to tell them, that they'd repent, and God in his mercy would forgive them. And he was like so many of us, he wanted them to get what was coming to them. Amen. But it wasn't the plan of God. God had another plan. Somebody say amen. I believe that. Amen. He tried to play God. As our text unfolds, he's in trouble. And let me tell you something. He knew he was in trouble. You ever been in trouble and knew you was in trouble? I have. Amen. Yes. I've been in trouble. Nobody didn't have to say James Chambers. We was making a little joke before church about our full names. That's what our parents called us when we was in trouble. James Howard Chambers. I knew something was wrong. Amen. Get in there and see what's wrong. I called Tommy the name. I said, Tommy Lee Harris. He said, what'd I do? Amen. Said he hadn't heard that. Said his mama used to say it like that. Tommy Lee Harris. Amen. But that'll get you, you know when you're in trouble. And Jonah knew he was in trouble. Amen. He knew it. Nobody had to tell him when that seaweed was choking the life out of him. And that mess, that nasty stuff, the insides of this fish was all over him. And he thought God didn't see him no more. And he sure couldn't see God right then. Amen. He knew he was in trouble. Amen. And I want to tell you, he seemed to be at a place in his life where he was through with God and God was through with him. And I'm just going to give you a one-liner on that. That's a dangerous place to be. That's a dangerous place to find yourself when you think God's through, his mercy's through, and you've looked at him the last time. You ought to find the strength just to look through this mess and look back to him one more time. And you'll find that over and over and over again, God has been faithful. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Bible says it's a dangerous thing, fearful thing to fall in the hands of a living God. Hallelujah. And that's what he done right there. And that's why when he looked up, God looked down. Amen. Aren't you thankful for today you looked up and he looked down? I mean, none of us are, you know, we've all sinned and come short of the glory of God. If you want to match evil things you did, I probably could match it. Amen. Because I was lost and undone without God or His Son. But I looked up and He looked down. Amen. And straightened everything out. Amen. In my life. That's where Jonah put himself. When he tried to play God, he put himself in that place where the Bible talks about him when he says it's a fearful thing to fall in the hands of a living God.
Right.
Amen. Jeremiah would have told him, don't say never. Amen. Jeremiah would have told him, said, don't mess up, Jonah. Don't say never. Don't say you're not ever going to look at God again. Because I said the same things. And I found out I had to look at God one more time. Somebody hear me tonight. God's gifts and His callings, the Bible teaches us, is without repentance. Amen. He don't take them back. Amen. If you've been called to preach, you'll carry that to the grave. Somebody say amen. 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 A backslid preacher must be the most miserable man in the world. Amen. I've failed God a few times, but I had never just completely quit on God since I've been called to preach. I've got slack and hurting and had to look back at Him one more time and get things straightened out in my life. Amen. Somebody hear me, but I cannot imagine being lost and undone without God or His Son all over again. Right. I can't imagine going back to where I was, amen, and fighting and living in hell and in the clutches of Satan where he could just snap me out at any moment. And I could, the day I got saved, Betty and I were going to a tent meeting on Sunday afternoon. And I just veered off the road a little bit, and I looked, and there's a great big incline down there. And if I'd have kept going, me and her probably lost her life that day. But I went to tent meeting with her mom and daddy and got saved that Sunday afternoon.
Amen.
Jesus made the difference in our life. Amen. I'm so glad. You can quit, and you cannot speak His name, and you cannot preach repentance to the lost. But I don't think you'll ever get rid of what Jeremiah was talking about when he said it shut up in my bones. I don't think you'll ever get rid of that simply because God don't take it back. Amen. God don't take it back. It will follow you one more time to the grave. I'm about to get through. If you just discouraged tonight because of something you've been praying for has not yet been answered or has not been as yet answered, somebody hear me tonight. The song says, friend, don't be discouraged. He might seem to be 4 days late to you, but he's really right on time. Somebody hear me tonight.
Right.
Take another look at him.
Right.
Don't be hesitant to call on the Lord again. He's listening for your call. Elijah, who had a double portion of Elijah's spirit laid upon a dead child twice before he was healed. Daniel prayed for 21 days before he got an answer. Jesus prayed twice for a blind man before he could see clearly. Amen. Joshua walked 13 times around Jericho and led the army around it 7 days before the walls fell flat. Amen. Naaman went down 7 times before there was any difference in his skin. Amen.
Amen.
Somebody hear me. Yeah, I'm just, only difference, probably it hurt worse getting that muddy Jordan River in those open sores. And he hurt worse, but when he went down the seventh time.
Amen.
Look at God one more time. Go down the seventh time. Hallelujah. 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 Elijah, who prayed fire down from heaven, sent his servant to see if there were any clouds 7 times while he was praying for rain before he saw a small cloud. This man's size, or size of a man's hand. Amen. Abraham waited from age 75 to age 100 for Isaac that God had promised. Amen. Just look at God one more time. Just look at God one more time. Somebody ought to get that in your spirit tonight. Just look at God one more time. Jeremiah said all we had to do was call on Him. Jeremiah 33:3, call on me and I will answer. Amen. And show you great mighty things that you know not. In closing, as I close tonight, if the devil tells you not to call on God, he'll come on back to the music. that he will not answer you. You need to tell him something tonight. He's a liar. And call God one more time in your life.
Amen.
Call on God one more time. Amen? Yes. Amen. You need to remember that the disciples said to Jesus, what the disciples said to Jesus when he told them to put the net back in the water, when they cleaned it all, cleaned it up. He said, Master, we've toiled all night and hadn't caught nothing. But at thy word, we'll put down the net. Amen. I'm telling you, somebody just needs to call on them one more time. I'm talking to somebody tonight. Yes. God's talking to somebody tonight. Just need to call on him one more time. Amen. Yes. Remember, Jesus said, remember and hear what the unjust judge saith. Because she just keeps calling me. I'm going to avenge her of her adversaries. There was a point there. You don't worry, God. But you need to be faithful with your petition to God.
Right.
If the devil never gets you, quit calling on God. You'll be like Jeremiah saying, we'll speak his name no more. You're going to call on him no more. And find yourself in a miserable, backslidden, unsaved, on your way to hell place.
Right.
Amen. Amen. And you'll need to find God. And I'll tell you, the only place to find him is to look back to him one more time. David said, I'm going to look into the hills from whence cometh my help. Just look back to God one more time and say, God, I know I've messed up. I mean, sometimes we just mess up and we outdo ourselves. We mess up worse than we've ever messed up. Amen. We get further away from God than we've ever been away from God. And sometimes, thank God I've never been in a fish's belly, but sometimes I feel like I can feel that mess around me choking the life out of me. And I'm fixing to be lost and undone without God when I look up to him one more time and I call on God one more time. That's what you need to do tonight. Amen. Could encourage somebody to call on him one more time tonight. Ask God to look at your situation one more time. We get excited in life when lawyers, doctors, policemen, bankers, or whatever we're dealing with said, I hadn't looked at your case lately. Let me look at it one more time. If you can get the banker to look at it one more time. If you can get the doctor to look at it and see if there's anything that you've overlooked that you can do for me to help me. How much more would it benefit us if we'd say, God, look at my case one more time. God, pull James Chambers back up before you one more time and just see if there's something you can do to change my situation. And I'm sure he can. Amen. Sure he can change your situation. Look at God one more time. I could stand here all night just saying over and over again, and you turn me off in a little bit, but I could just look you in the eye and say, look at God one more time. I could say it again, look at God one more time, and I could just keep repeating that till the midnight came, until the daylight came in the morning. And if you hadn't looked at him, you need to hear me say it one more time. Look at God one more time. One more time. Stand to your feet. Amen. Praise the Lord. Such a merciful God, Donnie. I love him so much. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Mary Weaver took time, I hope, to pull off the side of the road and maybe in the motel. She's on the road in Ohio. She said, please pray for her, one of our members. We love her so much. My niece, like a youngin' to us almost. Barbara Robinson asked to continue to pray for her back pain. Steve Fuel, several on the prayer list watching tonight. Pray for Steve that God will touch him. I just know it. I know in my spirit that there's somebody. You didn't call in, you didn't text in, but there's somebody that God is speaking to right through this airwaves tonight to tell you, you better look at God one more time while you still got a chance. I told you. In the onset of the message, there's people in hell today that would give anything had they looked at God one more time before they died and went to hell. You got an opportunity. You breathing. You can follow a mirror. You got breath tonight. And all you got to do is exercise that energy to Him and look at Him one more time. And He'll come to where you're at. I feel like this message is straight from God for some individuals tonight. Maybe somebody here. Maybe you give up on your children or your relatives, and they ain't ever going to straighten up. They're getting meaner than they ever was. You need to look at God one more time. Look at God one more time. You got a personal situation. Look at God one more time. I'm pray for these that called in. Pray for you streaming and the one that I know is out there somewhere listening to me tonight. I wish you'd call, but if you don't call, I'll go to bed tonight with full assurance that somebody heard this message tonight that was near as hell and needed to hear it. And if you'll turn around now and look to God, God will save your soul. Father, in Jesus' name, Lord, I pray that you touch these tonight that need this message the most, those that are in the most trouble tonight with God, that they look at God one more time. If they're in sin, trouble with God, or if they're sick tonight and the very life's about to get out of their body tonight, God, that they'll look at God one more time and pray till God turns this thing around in Jesus' name. God, touch all these. Barbara, heal that pain. Mary Weaver, put angels around her, Lord, and comfort her. If she's under the sound of my voice right now, comfort her right now and put guardian angels all around her tonight on the road back from Ohio. God, touch Steve Fuel, Lord. Give him strength to get to church soon. Love to see him Sunday, Lord. God, Easter Sunday, Lord, I believe you're going to send people in Sunday. We're thanking you for it. We're believing you for it, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Let Steve be one of them. Some of the others that have been sick, Lord, Brother Logan, Lord, told me today his desire was to get back in church. Lord, help him to do that, God. Colleen, Lord, help her to get back with us again, Lord. Those that's been out, Brother and Sister Wilson, Ralph, Shirley, their family, Lord, get them all back with us, Lord. Debbie Brooks, Lord, help her to get back to church, Lord. All these that's been away and been out, Lord, I pray for them tonight. God, that as we look at you one more time, you'll make a way when there seems to be no way. God, touch King's family as they dealt this week with the loss of another loved one, God. Touch all the sick. Thank you for taking care of Pastor Poole with his eye surgery, Lord. Thank you for watching over the Dallas Church and the Gastonia Church and the Warrensboro Church. Thank you for taking care of the TV ministry, Lord. God, everything that's done, we give you all the praise. Bless us Sunday. Let us have a wonderful Easter weekend here in this sanctuary tonight that needs to look at God one more time. God, that you'd help them as well as the streaming congregation tonight to look at God one more time. And we'll thank you for it in Jesus' name. Amen and amen and amen. Love you tonight, Lord. We magnify you. We worship you, Lord. We praise you tonight. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Would you just say that prayer tonight? God, if I ever get to the place Jonah was in, God, help me to look back at you one more time, because I don't want to be lost when I leave this life. Amen. I don't want to be lost while I'm living this life, but I certainly don't want to be lost if I get to that dire moment like I almost got to 5 years ago at 64 years old. I almost went out to meet God. I'm glad I was saved, but I'm glad you give me 5 more years to preach, Lord, never how much time I got left. I thank you for it all in Jesus' name. Give you all the praise in Jesus' name. Help me to never run from the call as Betty's singing. God bless you. Thank you for being with us. Thank you for streaming with us. Sorry to inform you, won't be no TV this week. But we'll be back on next Saturday night. Donnie will be singing. We'll be back to worship the Lord. Lord willing, you'll be back with us next Saturday night at 9 o'clock. But until then, pray for us. We're praying for you. Again, I regret to tell you that I felt like it was the best thing at the time to do. We've done something every year since I've been here, except last year and this year. That's not have a sunrise service, but I felt it was within the plan of God, at least, that we'd not do it again this year. Maybe not in His plan, but His permissive will anyway. Amen. Be here at 11 o'clock for worship Sunday morning. Be a part. I know people, some people going on vacation, going off. But if you're going to be here, be in God's house Sunday morning. God bless you. Thank you for streaming with us. Good night, everybody. Hope you have a good rest of the week.